what I have here on page 269 of the basic textbook is that the answer to that is racist man and racist woman, and these are the white supremacists,
yes,
collectively, sometimes do much to help a particular religion to be more emotionally comforting to non-white people. In other words, you'll find a lot of comfort in their religion because they will allow that from an emotional viewpoint. But they will help a religion to be more appealing to non-white people in regards to singing or dancing. Now, singing or dancing is a part of many, many religious ceremonies. So the white supremacists look at the effect of singing and dancing, hand clapping, and things like that, and they will make an assessment of it, and they'll say, oh, well now, is that harmful to the business of white supremacy? They say, well, we don't see any evidence of that, so we will allow those non-white people to sing and dance as a part of their religious ceremony. We will allow that. Why? Because the singing and dancing is no threat to us.
Okay.
See, the white supremacists only object to what you're doing if it's a threat to the business of white supremacy, which means mistreating people based on color. So they'll look at that and they'll say, well, that actually, the singing and dancing seems to give comfort to the people. They feel better about themselves. They feel better about their situation in the world. It relieves the pressure and whatnot. And they look at that. They are very scientific. And they say, oh, well, we'll not only allow them to sing and dance, we'll help them to sing and dance. You know, if it relieves the pressure in our prison system called the prison of white supremacy, we'll allow our prisoners to sing and dance. We want them to be happy behind the prison walls, you know, that we have set up. And so it says here, they allow that and they encourage that.
Yes.
They will help or allow non-white people to get more thrills or more fun out of one or more religious practices.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so that your religion becomes thrilling. It becomes fun. I mean, you feel better. You feel better about everything going on around you.
Mm-hmm.
And the white supremacists want that in your religion. They don't want you to feel, when you, as a part of your religion, like something that's seriously out of order, that needs to be corrected, that you really need to get on it and start thinking about maybe getting rid of whatever is causing the misery and whatnot. They want you to feel good about the misery.
Yes.
And so they will always help you to make your religion fun. You know, everybody likes fun. And this is why a lot of black people will say after a religious ceremony, they will say what? We really had a good time. You know, last time we were had our religious ceremony, that was really a good ceremony, and we really enjoyed ourselves. That's why they don't disapprove of,
I see,
of religion. So, I mean, among non-white people, until you do what? Until you start saying, well, we are going to do something about stopping people from being mistreated. Now, you and your religion are going to be in trouble.
Yes.
The minute you go down that road.
Yes.
If you're going to do anything to stop people from being mistreated, the white supremacists are in the mistreatment business. So you are now stomping on their business, and they are not going to have that. They are going to stomp on you.
Person.
They will get on your case. You will always know. All you got to do is just try to seriously help the people who really need help. All right? I mean, in a serious manner, on a large scale. All right? And that will, you know, include a lot of non-white people, maybe.
Okay.
The white supremacist said, hey, if I wanted to give them some help, I would give them help. You know, now you're going to start giving them help on my watch, using my facilities, Negro? No, you're not. Not on my planet. If I want to help somebody, I'll give them the help. I help you. I allow you to practice your religion on my planet. And don't you ever forget it.
Mm.
And if you get out of line, I got 1,000 ways of putting you out of business.